Hey, All Late But Great, this is Jim here from Ohio, and it is Friday, and I am your host on Fridays on the channel Out Late But Great. So Maya picked the topic of the week, and I'm going to read it to you. You're new to this. So far, you've only come out to a few people. You have friends who have expressed anti-LGBT views because of their religious teachings. They are a long-term part of your life and connected network. You need to find a way to come out to them while causing the least damage to yourself and them. How do you do it? Have you ever done it? Well, as far as myself, no. I mean, I came out 25 years ago, and when I came out, I just came out to everybody, and I never had to deal with bad feelings from my friends or my family. I guess I was pretty lucky because I have heard horror stories, but it's funny. I looked up the definition of homophobia in the dictionary, and I wanted to read it to you. The definition of homophobia is unreasoning fear or antipathy towards homosexuality and homosexuals. And I think a lot of homophobia or fear comes from the unknown. So many people years ago pretended or acted like they never knew any gay people. And well, it turns out they were all around them, but that was because most people back in the day were in the closet. And that's where fear and hate comes from, the unknown. Harvey Milk said it the best. He said it back years and years ago. He said the best way to combat homophobia is just to come out and be open and be honest about yourself to your friends and your family. And that really, really makes a difference. It really does. We've talked about that before. I mean, I can't tell you the amount of people in my life, my coworkers, friends that I know that have really changed their opinion of gay people just because they knew me. And the same thing with Dave. And you know, it really does make a difference. You know, we're seeing that now with these, we talked about that last weekend, with these crazy politicians this Islamophobia. They're afraid of Muslims and stuff. And it's because, you know, we don't really know any Muslims. Most people don't. So it's easy to target people that way and cause hate. You know, 98% of Muslims, 99% of Muslims are very, very peaceful people. Yet we have politicians that are running that want to ban them from coming into the United States or have them, I don't know what, wear badges or patches. I mean, it is so ridiculous. And I'll give you an example about friends and friends, especially at work. I mean, I think I told you a couple months ago, in January, my coworkers had a big party for Dave and I for the fact that we got married. And I, you know, I thought just a few people would come. I didn't know. Well, over 60 people came. So I can't tell you how that made me feel. And it's because they know us. They know that we're just regular people and they were there to support us. I have a friend who, before he came out, his mother was very, very anti-gay. And when he finally came out to her, things really started switching and changing. And I have to laugh. He said, oh my God, now she's like draped in the rainbow flag because she is such a supporter of gay rights. And it's because she realized that someone that she loved, someone that she knew very, very well, her own son, was gay. So I think that's the key. I really do. You have to just come out to these people. And you know, if I will bet that they will accept you. I really will. But you know, if they don't, then you have to make some decisions about your own life, whether you want these people in your life, because you cannot live your life for someone else. You can't. And you have to be honest and open. And that is the only way to live, guys. It really is. So anyway, that's really all I got to say. This is Easter weekend, so if you guys celebrate Easter, I hope you have a great Easter, and I will talk to you again next Friday. Take care. Love you. Be good.